Right, so this is a video about making a video. That's my brother there. He's testing out a new electric bike. He's doing a review on it, and I'm helping him do the review. So I'm going to be doing some of the filming, the drone flying, following him around, and it should be a fun morning.
Some explaining to do, but this was very kindly sent to me. The Himiway fat tired all-terrain bike, e-bike. Now Himiway reached out to me and they said would I like to review their Himiway Cruiser long distance e-bike, and I said, well, e-bikes aren't my thing. I like to use my legs, but nothing against e-bikes. But I went back to them. They were going to send me the man's version, if you like. These bikes are available in three different types. You've got a mountain bike, the Himiway Cruiser, and the Himiway Cruiser Step Through. Now, my wife Mandy is physically compromised. She's had a major heart surgery. She finds cycling very difficult. And so I went back to Himiway and I told them, well, if they want to send me a step-through model, that would be more suitable for my wife, and it would enable her to get out and use an e-bike for transport and for pleasure, and also for a bit of physical exercise, which she needs, because she can't ride a normal bike. So this bike is for Mandy, for my wife. So let's get it unboxed. You can see it's quite a big box. It weighs 70 odd pounds, 72 pounds. I'll put the specs up as we go along, or I'll talk more about it, but let's get it open. Well, there's the first look in the box. It all looks very neat. Certainly very well packaged. Let's get it out. Build it up. Well, you can see it's really been well packaged. I'm surprised actually at how substantial and heavy it feels, especially the forks. They feel very very durable. Anyway, I've still got a bit more unpacking to do, so I'm going to carefully remove the packaging material, build the bike up. Amanda's getting excited, she can't wait to ride it. This is the box that comes with the bike. So there's probably a few extras in here, like pedals and possibly some assembly. Oh, Himiway hat.
Oh, hey.
I better put that on. Don't worry, the Wiltshire man's hat will be coming back on again soon. Does it suit me?
It does, actually.
Oh, there's your front skewer for the front wheel. I'm not sure what that is just yet. Oh, tool kit. Brilliant.
Told you, didn't I?
Yeah, yeah. Tool kit. So that is really, really super useful. All the different sizes you need on there. Brilliant. What a great thing to include in the bike. So that's that. What have we got here? Front lights. Pedals. Instructions. Maybe I should have to read them in a minute. And in this box here, this is obviously the controller.
And the charger.
And the charger. Oh, that's the charger, sorry, yeah. That's the charger. Right, so yeah, let's get the bike built up. So, using the supplied toolkit, I'm able now to put the handlebars on. Just saw this. Please watch the installation video before installing the e-bike handlebar. So I'll be back in a sec. Pretty straightforward, really. It's just a matter of putting the forks the right way, making sure it's all facing forward, and then fitting the handlebars. Don't fit them too tight, it says, to start off with, because you might have to make some final adjustments. So I'm just going to loosely fit the handlebars and then move on to fitting the front wheel. Right, we're almost there, almost there. Next thing to do is to put the pedals on, and then we're ready to give it a test ride. So pedals are handed. You've got right and left. If you can't see which way they go on, because if you put them on the wrong way round, or the wrong pedal into the wrong thread, you'll damage the thread. But a tip that I've heard is that on these flat pedals, it wants to be sloping forwards like that. You see that one there? It's sloping backwards. So that wants to go on the other side. So this is the right pedal for this side. And then it should just screw on. They're all right hand threads. Just put it on there. Nip it up, same the other side. That's it, let's tighten that one up. Just nip it up. Check it all spins freely, and that's the bike assembled.
Well, here it is, the Himiway Cruiser in step through, the step through model. I'll tell you what, I'm really impressed by the build quality of this bike. Electric e-bike. I've got some notes with me, and I'll read you through the notes that I've made. But first of all, I'll have a quick walk around the bike, and then we'll highlight a few things. Himiway kindly sent me this bike, and I'm really impressed by the build quality of it. And the first thing that I noticed were the sort of the actual fit and finish of everything, especially the handlebars. It's got a twist grip. Now, in overseas model, this is always wired to go to full power when you twist it through increments. But on the UK model, it basically just is a walk assist. So I think it'll go to about 4 miles per hour, and that's its limit. Well, the frame is a high quality 6061 aluminium frame, and which apparently gives it a great deal of durability. The motor. Now, this is something I'm not absolutely sure about, because in the UK we're governed to 250 watts, but if I understand correctly, this could well be a 750 watt motor that has been
programmed in software or locked down, if you like, to give the UK limit of 250 watts output. Now, if that's the case, that could well mean that the motor is very durable because it's overbuilt for what it's going to be doing in the UK. And I believe, but don't quote me, I believe that if you watch certain videos, there's certain sequences of buttons you can press and you can unlock it. But that might well bring you into conflict with the UK law. So if you get stopped with a bike which has been unlocked, you could well be breaking the law, shall we say. But I'm not sure about that. So it might be a 250 watt motor, but it could be a 750 watt motor. The acceleration is fast. It does accelerate very quickly, especially if you put it into the top power pedal assist number 5. It does say about the geared motor that it uses the latest updated inner ring specialised in high temperature resistance and for better heat dissipation, which can reduce the motor magnet's attenuation speed for a guaranteed longer life expectancy. So it's a brushless gear hub motor. Apparently it's got 80 newton meters of torque, and underneath the bike, and I believe this is the controller here, this unit here, apparently that is 48 volt 22 amp controller. The battery, let's have a look at it from the other side. You've got a lock to take the battery on and off. Go around into the sunlit side. Himiway electric bikes are equipped with Samsung LG 48 volt 17.5 amp hour batteries to ensure long life expectancy and distinguished performance, it says. A single charge range can be up to 60 plus miles on pedal assist mode. Total battery capacity is 840 watt hours. Right. Who's it for? Well, it says recommended rider heights 5'2" to 6'4". So that's basically 95% of the adult population it will fit. Maximum payload capacity, now this is impressive. It's 350 pound, which is 25 stone. So that's a lot of shopping there. And talking about shopping, look at the rack. All comes with the bike, sturdy as you like. I haven't seen a rack as strongly built as that ever. That's fantastic. Brakes, these are cable disc brakes. I prefer the cables. On my other bike I've got hydraulics. Hydraulics are lovely, they've got a better feel, but when hydraulics go wrong, you've got a real headache. But with these, it's something you can fix yourself. It's easy. So you've got cable disc brakes back and front. Tyres, just look at them. Huge, great fat tyres. Now, these can range in tyre pressures from 5 psi up to 30 psi. I think they're currently about 25. And you just sail over the bumps. You don't even feel the bumps hardly. Drive train, Shimano, a good quality Shimano, cassette, Shimano Altus derailleur on the back, and you've got a single, quite a large front chain ring. So, yeah, if you are going to be climbing hills, you're going to want your pedal assist to be helping you, because it's not really geared too low, as you can see. I did notice that the tyres are also, it says puncture resisting casing, so hopefully punctures will not occur too frequently. And there's the quick release on the front there. I'm really impressed. Lights, oh yeah, we've got to talk about the lights, but you won't see them very much. It's quite a bright day today. You've got a front light equipped with the bike, and on the back You've got a backlight under the rack, and this also comes on as a brake light when you pull on the brakes. Interesting feature, another interesting feature is that the brakes have got a couple of wires going to each brake. So when you pull on the brakes, this disengages the motor. Got a nice bell as well. So it's got a nice bell, a nice ring to the bell. That this is your gear change. So 7 speeds. And you can marry that up to your pedal assist. Your pedal assist is all controlled from this this unit here. On button, lights on and off. Pedal assist up and down. This one's set at the moment for five different ranges of pedal assist, with one being the lowest and five being the highest. And it really does zip you along. The other thing I got to mention is it comes with a side stand. This is a really, really good idea, and it's so easy. Just, you know, walk the bike to where you want to park it, or ride it to where you want to park it, and just get off and clip the side stand down. And it feels like it's sprung loaded in some sort of a way. The bike itself isn't the lightest of bikes. It weighs 72 pound, which is about 35 kilo, I think. 32.7 kilograms. So it's not the lightest of bikes, but I have ridden it with no pedal assist, and surprisingly it pedals quite nicely. So yeah, the fat tyres aren't holding it back too much. The thing is, though, as I said, this bike is really for my wife, and so when she feels ready, we're going to see how she gets on with it. As I say, Mandy is partially disabled with a fairly serious heart condition. So she's going to really benefit from the pedal assist. But as you can see, it's a bit of a beast. It's a well-built bike. So I'm currently in pedal assist number 3, and this is an incline, which would normally cause me to be slightly out of breath, I'd say, on a normal bike. On the Himiway Cruiser, I'm not breathing heavy at all. Let's go on to, I'm on number 5, setting number 5 now, 24, 25 kilometres an hour up the hill. Oh, no, I'm not out of breath one tiny little bit. Let's just negotiate through the gateway here. So it really depends on how you want to ride the bike, because if you set a lower pedal assist mode, you can generally reach that speed by using normal pedal power, and then obviously you're relying upon your own steam after that. So going over some fairly rough terrain, muddy terrain at the moment, and the tyres are finding it really easy. So what's the bike like at night? Well, there's the tail light illuminated. That's the display, so it's clearly visible in darkness, and the front lights. So you've got twin headlights, and they're throwing a pretty reasonable beam. Certainly bright enough to negotiate a dark path through a woodland at night time. When the brakes are applied, the lights, they flash. I'm riding through pitch black really along a cycle track here through the middle of a woodland, and doing absolutely fine. No problem with the headlights. They're not the brightest, but they are sufficient. Okay, well, it's another day now, and we're out on the two bikes. I'm on my normal conventional pedal bicycle, which is a boot zipper. Mandy's riding the Himiway, so she has ridden it a couple of times now, but I didn't film those. But she's getting on with it really well, and she's just behind me. We're currently riding along a slight incline. So we've got a slight incline, we're going uphill a little bit. I'm having to put a little bit of power on using leg muscles. But I think, oh, there she goes, look. Oh, sailing past me. Oh. We'll ask her how she's getting on. I think she's really loving the bike. And we're gonna test it in a minute on a much steeper hill. So we'll get her impressions shortly. So there you go, that's Mandy, look. How are you finding the bike then?
Quite easy, quite good.
You're finding it easy?
I'm getting used to it now, yeah.
Yeah, you're getting used to it. And saddle, what's the saddle like for you?
Ah, it's nice.
It's a nice saddle?
Yeah.
Yeah. So, we're gonna ride around these woods. These woods are fairly flat at the moment, and then we're gonna head off. I've got a very bright sun in my eyes at the moment. Then we're gonna head off up a steep hill and on for a longer distance ride, and Mandy's gonna see how she gets on with it at the hills. But I've just got to say that this is a game changer for Mandy, because she's had a major heart surgery. She's had a replacement aortic valve. She's had a pulmonary embolism. She's had some fairly serious physical conditions. She's had an ankle fusion. So it's not possible for her to ride a conventional bicycle. So she needs something like an e-bike. And I got to say, I think she's really loving it. So as you can see, we've got a lovely bright sunny day today, and it's just a nice day to be out on the bike. It's muddy here, and the e-bike just going through it like a tractor. So anyway, this one here, it went through there, no problem at all, did it?
Yeah.
And you felt?
I was going to slip, and I didn't.
No, it wasn't slippery at all.
I took my time, took a bit of careful on it, because it's the first time I've done it.
Yeah. Well done, man. Let's tackle the steep hill then, yeah?
Which one have we got? Which way are we going to go? That way?
Yeah, that way, yeah.
Go on.
Right.
I'm happy.
Well, we're on a fairly steep hill. Oh, she's going past me, look. Oh, goodness. Crones. She's finding the hills easy, I think. Yeah, she's she's definitely got the advantage on me now on the hills, thanks to that pedal assist on the e-bike. Fair steep hill, but I'm getting there.
What took you so long?
Pardon?
What took you so long?
Oh, that's right, you can talk, can't you? How did you find that bike then?
All right, okay, nice.
Nice, is it?
Would you like a cup of tea, Sandy?
Yeah, here he is, look, here's Dave. He's got the kettle on.
Yeah, it is on now.
Okay, so we're heading through a little hamlet called Kingston Winslow. Down a hill. And then up a steep hill the other side. So we'll see how she does. Right, I'm at the top of the hill now almost. Here comes Mandy on the Himiway. Let's see how she does. I'm a bit out of breath. So bearing in mind Mandy's major heart surgery. So there's the bike, needs a good clean now. Mandy cycled up the hill and down the hill. How did you find it then?
Great.
You like the bike, do you?
I do, actually, yeah.
And it's managed to get you out, hasn't it?
Yeah.
And so there you go, look, there's no excuse now for a little bit of exercise. It does give her a bit of exercise, which is what you want. But she's able now to negotiate virtually all the hills, I say, around where we go. And so far, we're on 4 bars, 70, when we left home it was on 40 kilometres, now we're on 71.6 and it's dropped down to from 5 bars down to 4, so that's pretty impressive. And the other thing I forgot to mention also, it's got massive great mounting points on the front of the bike. This is for a front carrier. And it is really a substantial piece of kit. So basically the Himiway is an all-terrain ultra utility electric bicycle, I'd say. A very rugged piece of kit by the looks of it. So here we are, we're in Ashbury Village Stores and they do lovely coffees and cakes and snacks. And so far Mandy's cycled about 12 miles.
I should think so.
12 miles, and that's something she would never have been able to do. So I think she's very grateful. Thanks to him, anyway. Aren't you?
Yeah, thanks to him.
And we're really enjoying this lovely sustenance. So a big shout out to Ashbury Village Stores. And there's the staff over there, look.
Bye!
Well, there she is, back home, look. And now I don't know if you can see it on the screen there.
Dark,
a
perfect
day. 24.51 miles.
Yeah.
So we cycled 24 and a half miles, which is not an insignificant amount of distance to cycle. And Mandy it would have been impossible for her without having the e-bike assist. So a bike like the Himiway has given Mandy a life back in a way, because you know, health compromised, she wouldn't have been able to cycle no more than a mile, maybe two at the most. But she's got up the hills. How are you feeling?
Fine. I'm a little teeny weeny bit out of breath, not too much though.
No, so you've had some exercise, haven't you?
Yeah, and I enjoyed it.
She's had some exercise.
I quite enjoyed myself.
She's enjoyed it, and
they will go on another day, I will do, definitely.
The Himiway's given her a life back, I reckon. So before I forget, we're on three bars on the battery now, so that's gone from 5 bars down to 3 and in 24 and a half miles, plus I did 10 mile last night out with the bike filming, so in 35 and a half miles we've I charged it up since then, so in 35 and a half mile I've gone from the full battery which is 5 bars down to 3 bars, so yeah, I'd say that pretty much is a long range e-bike. that's it, end of this video. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.
Bye. No, I really enjoyed myself.